Next, we will look at the Schedules tab on the left. Up at the top, Schedule Sets tab, this shows schedule sets. You can think of a schedule set as a collection of various different schedules, and this schedule set will be applied to a space type. A schedule set has various different schedules for people and loads located within a space. For the fire station schedule set, we have people occupancy levels throughout the day, people activity levels in watts of heat output per person. We also have lighting watt density levels that vary throughout the day, electric equipment, gas equipment, water, steam, and also infiltration. You can drop a schedule into a schedule set just as easily as going to the My Model tab or the Library tab and dragging and dropping. We'll do an example for this storage room schedule set. If we had a gas equipment load located within the storage space, we would just simply grab a gas schedule set or gas schedule and drop it into the storage schedule set. That's an example, but we don't have it for this instance, so we'll delete this. Likewise, creating a new schedule set is as easy as pushing the plus button. Renaming it to whatever schedule you want. And dragging and dropping various components into the schedule set. Next, we will go to the Schedules tab. These are the individual schedules. Let's look at this one. Always on. This is a common type of schedule used for energy modeling to override equipment to ensure that the equipment is in the on position throughout the entire year. The default schedule for this is 1. Likewise, we can create a new schedule just by copying the plus 2 on here, and we will call this always off. To change the value to 0, hover over the line and type in 0. Enter. Now, this is always off. There are different other types of schedules priorities located within each of these schedules. For example, if you have a specific override for sizing equipment using design day values, you can create a custom schedule just for sizing the equipment. That would be the summer design and the winter design schedule. Let's look at a different schedule, clothing schedule. Here, the default value is 1. Basically, everybody in the building is wearing long pants, long shirts, and coats throughout the entire day. You'll notice that there's also a priority schedule here. Let's click it. This priority schedule is applicable between May and the end of September basically the summer months. This schedule is saying that during this period, people located within the building are basically half-dressed. That is, they're not wearing coats and they're probably not wearing long pants. They're wearing lighter clothing. If we wanted to create a custom schedule during the spring period, we would simply just click the plus button. Let's just copy schedule rule number one, add it to the project, this is called schedule rule number two. We'll do this for the spring months. During the spring days, the shoulder seasons, if you will, people will enter the building probably with coats and heavy sweaters on, as it is cold in the morning. And then later in the day, they will shed some of those clothing. To split the schedule, simply double-click on the line. We will change the morning hours to 1, saying that the occupants probably have long coats and sweaters on. Around midday, the occupants shed those sweaters and coats as it gets warmer in the building. That's an example of how to change the schedule. Let's create a schedule for a thermostat set point. You can simply go to the library as we imported our library before. And let's look for a thermostat schedule. For the apparatus bay, the temperature will be held constant throughout the year at a freeze protection set point. So you can just drag this schedule into the schedules library, drop it here. And you'll notice that it was dropped into our schedules. The default value is to maintain the space at 38 degrees, basically above freezing. You'll notice that there are two different priorities on the weekend, Saturday and Sunday. Sunday, the space is held at 60 degrees, possibly for some sort of functions during Sundays. Likewise, on Saturdays, the space is raised up to 70 degrees, basically room temperature. So they must have some sort of closed, indoor, occupied community function that goes on Saturdays. And that's just throughout the day. Let's create an HVAC schedule for heating. Click the plus button, select the type of schedule, temperature, click apply, and we'll call this heating HVAC. The building is occupied 24/7 and operational 24/7. So this will be a simple schedule. All we have to do is hover over the line and type in 70 degrees, basically room temperature. That tells the HVAC equipment to maintain the space temperature throughout the entire 24 hours of the day at 70 degrees. Let's create another schedule, but let's copy this schedule. Push the times 2 button, and we'll call this cooling HVAC. Change this value to 75. And we'll say that cooling has a night setback just to save energy. double-click on the line to create a break. Hover over the morning hours and type in 80. Double-click on the other side of the line to create a break and hover over it, type 80. This sets the thermostat back during the nighttime so that the building is not being actively cooled. That way, during the daytime, the building is actively cooled and the cooling system essentially shuts off at nighttime. If you want to look at the schedule in more detail, you can zoom in using these buttons down here, 15-minute increments. You can see it starts at 7 and ends at 5. You can also adjust by dragging the vertical line. And you can zoom in even further to 1-minute increments. Let's say the cooling gets set back at 4:28 in the afternoon. That's how you create a schedule. Let's say there's a time during the summer where the fire station is closed for 1 week. Let's create a custom priority override schedule for that. Click the plus button. New profile, yes. Click add. Then select the priority. And we'll say June shutdown. We'll just say it's the first week of June. For the first week of June, we don't need any cooling at all. And we'll say it's all week long. So we'll select all of these days. You'll notice as you select those days, it changes over here. This purple shows where the active schedule that you're working on is affected throughout the entire year. We'll override this to 80 degrees. There. So that's an example of schedules. There are other different types of schedules. Laundry activity schedules. This is basically saying how many watts the people in the laundry room are putting out for heat. Lighting schedules. This says the lights go off at nighttime, they turn on at 8 in the morning, and then they shut down at about 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Gas schedules are similar. Infiltration schedules are a fractional schedule. And this is a multiplier that's multiplied by the total space infiltration that's applicable. There's also lighting schedules. You'll see that the locker room lighting goes on and off a lot in this schedule. This is probably because the firemen are going out to various different calls throughout the day and night, and they have to use the locker room to get suited up. So that's schedules in a nutshell. Please remember to click like and subscribe if you like this video.